Are you looking to build a simple web page using just HTML and CSS? Then this tutorial is for you. Hi everyone, my name is Jensen and I'm an instructor at Entrepify Academy. We upload new content on YouTube every Thursday. Today I'm going to walk you through the process of building a simple portfolio web page that you can use to land a new job or a freelance gig. If at some point in this video you find something helpful, please click on the like and subscribe buttons and don't forget the notification bell so you don't miss any future events or videos. So let's hit it. All right, so let's get started. We're going to implement this design here. So let's see, what do we have? We have a header, about me section, and some lists of projects, as well as a simple to footer. All right, so let's see what we're going to implement that. So let me just make this a bit smaller. So this is the index page. It's pretty empty. So nothing there is yet. So let's start adding. But before maybe adding, maybe I could just basically have this as a full screen. And yeah, let's get started with the first section. All right, so let's get some introduction to the code base, and let's see what do we have in that template. So starting with the style sheet. So I have linked to the style sheet on the right side. There are also some links for the fonts. I'm using the Montserrat font with several weights, 400. 500, 700, and 900. Okay, so, and then on the CSS side, so what do I have here? As a kind of a base layer is some basic reset stylings and some colors. We're using your CSS variables, as well as some, for example, font sizes and font weight for some headers. So we have the same settings, like basically applied to all the HTML tags. All right, so first things first, what we're going to start with is the header, right? So we're going to build this part here. And what's HTML tag we are going to use in this case is basically the header tag. So, and that would have also a class called container fold. We're going to add the CSS later on, but in just a moment. So next up is the header. So we have the h1. This is the main header of the web page. I'm going to split it into two parts. So the first part is my name is. You can have your name there. The reason of splitting it to two parts is because you might notice here one has a different font weight than the other. So that's the reason of splitting them. Then we're gonna have the second span here. You might notice here that we have a mark tag, which has some CSS class. That's basically is what I want to do is that if I want to apply this primary gradient, all what I need to do is just wrap this text with a specific tag name or class name, and then the CSS would do its job for me and apply this, that basically the general styling for it. All right, so next up is we are going to add some action buttons here, the contact me, and some very long online SVG. So we're going to have access to this SVG and the code base. And by the way, we're going to share the code base or access to this code base in the link in the description below. All right, so where's next? Let's maybe see what do we have here at this point. So we have this kind of ugly looking header section, but let's make it a more beautiful. So we start with the CSS. So in this part here, I'm going to start with the header. So apply some display flex to it and like to the direction to be column. Here it's like in displaying flex, it might not be very necessary here. You could just basically use the HTML default display. So for example, H1 is a block and so on. So they are going to be anyway in a column way. But here I'm applying it just to have more maybe flexibility in aligning the content, whether to the left or right or center, stuff like that. So, and the last one is here for positioning. I'm applying this to be a relative, as because we're going to have an SVG, so that would be absolute to that, relatively to that header. Then later on, some basic styling for the span to be a block, and also for changing the weight of the maybe the first span, which is the title and the name. All right, so maybe just some styling for the SVGs, and let's see what do we get so far. Yeah, looking better. You can see the SVG on the right side and some text. So let's maybe add some gradient to it. So for that, adding gradient, we're going to, before that, you could notice already that the, maybe I can make this a bit smaller and maybe focus on the output instead. So you see that there is no padding on the left or right or any part. So I'm going to add some like general classes. One of them is the container false. So that would be applied to any section that its job is to be like on the full screen. So you here might be wondering why is that. We have two different layers. We have a layer for full screen, and we have a layer maybe for or section for something that in the center and not taking the entire width of the available screen. Okay, so next up is we're going to add some margin button and some primary gradient. So these are the MP2, the margin button 2 is basically some kind of custom utility class where you could use it anywhere on any tag that you want to have some margin buttons button on it. You can basically create your own. So we added the gradient. The gradient here is using some gradient values from primary color to the light color. So if you ask how you get this this gradient is, for example, if we're gonna take this gradient here from the design system or design file here, get selected, and you could like inspect. I'm not sure this might be a bit too small for you, but I don't think there is a way to zoom in Figma. But here at the bottom, you could see there is a background like property here, which basically Figma is telling us what is the CSS of that specific color, and that's how what I did basically. I just copied the file or the values all here, then I based on my CSS file. So let's see what do we have so far. Looks looking better, looking good here. What left is the buttons. So let's maybe add some styling to the buttons. So for that, we're going to have a some generic styling for the buttons. So all buttons will be following that specific configurations or properties. And then we might have add on top of it, like for example, if it's a button for primary, then add maybe a background to it or change the color. So that's basically if we want to have a secondary, we can add a secondary button that will basically consume from the origin and extend from the .btn class. All right, maybe some hovering to it. And then if we go now back to the output, you see now it looks better. Now we have also the hover effect. Okay, let's maybe move on to the next part. So the next part is let's take a look at the design. So it's the about me section. Here are the two things that we have to keep in mind, that it has a different background color than the body. Maybe you can see it, but it's can maybe see the contracts here. So it has a different background color, and the text is more narrower and it's in the center. So let's see how we can do that. In terms of HTML, so we're going to have a section. So the idea here, how I'm going to treat it is each section of this is going to be wrapped in a section tag and with some generic stylings. Okay, so here we have a section, and then there's a wrapper inside the section. So the idea of this wrapper here, you might be asking, why is that? So the wrapper is because this, for one reason is, one, it has a different background color, and the second is I want to narrow the text towards the center, and that's why I need to have balanced container that handles the background color, but the inner container handles the width of it, whether it could be narrow or wide, so it doesn't conflict. It doesn't conflict actually with the background here. Okay, so next up here is some title, and you can see we have applied the same class name here, primary gradient. So it's basically going to inherit whatever classes or whatever styles we have on the style CSS styles, and then some basically paragraphs, just random ones. And yeah, so right now if I save, and maybe let's go back to some styling to do some styling here. So first of all, it's because it has some different background, and we have width background that on the on this section. So I'm going to add some different color here. And then we have the about me section, so the text would be aligned. And then because it's the inner container, it would be center. So that's the one basically, no matter what's the width of it, that's not going to like conflict with the background here. We add some styling to it. And yeah, I think we also need the uppercase, if not now, maybe later on. Okay, so I'm going to save that file and let's take a look at the results here. So yeah, looking better. Maybe we need the uppercase because these are still lowercase, and I think that's the better now to do that. So we have uppercase and maybe some margin bottom at the bottom. So now looking better. All right, so let's keep on going, continue and see the second or fourth last section. So what is it going to be about? It's going to be about that project. So it's going to follow kind of the same layout, which section that would have maybe three different cards, which are the projects. And inside each card would have some other tags. Okay, so what we're gonna do here is we're going to create also that section that has some container to be full, that's not center. And then the same H2 tag, the header to tag. You see here, we're going into the hierarchy order. So we started with the header to be H1, and those the subsections or the sections in the page have the header too. So it's really important to go with the hierarchy and not to mix up with hierarchy here. So our next step is we're going to have the projects, and each inside the project step we have each project. So the project, each project has a title, some skills, and some descriptions, and two actions buttons. So one for to visit, and the other to basically view the source codes. These are buttons. This could be a trips. It's up to you. How do you want to deal with that? All right, so let's maybe add two more projects. So they are kind of the same tag, the same structure, but with different content. One here and the other, the last one is there. So now we have two more. Maybe let's save them and take a look at the results. So result looks like that. It's not the best. At least the buttons have inherited the BTN, the button that we have here. But the rest needs some working, mostly spacings. So let's see how we do that. If I go back to my the CSS, maybe let's just have this a bit smaller. Okay, so let's go back to the CSS. So what do we need to do here? Let's first take care of the project section to be all the text to be centered, and also the projects themselves, like the wrapper of each project. Let's have it as a grid. And with more of dynamic values. So basically the project will either increase in numbers and number of how many columns we have. So the narrower we go, it will be, for example, in desktop will be maybe three or four, but the narrower we go, then it will be less and less until we get to one fraction, which is on mobile. Would be each card would be a fraction of taking the entire width of the screen. Let's add some gaps, and for each project, we're going to add some background color and have some radius to it with some baddings. Then let's take a look at the basically more spacing to in under the title and above the description, as well as that's here we are going to style these skills, like these skills, so they have some nice gradient colors and maybe more as you can see here, more border radius, so it looks like a build. All right, so here are the actions, and now if I save this, what we're going to take is see now each card took its shape with some background and use the text tag there, but one more is about the button, so we're going to have it a bit more different. So the button already has a secondary. So let's add this secondary class. The secondary class is going to be like without the background and just basically focused on the text itself. So if we take a look at right now, how it looks like, it looks like that. Okay, cool. So we're getting closer to the towards the end. So now what we left up with maybe footer and some maybe responsiveness there or there. So let's talk about the footer. The footer is basically it's very, very base, straightforward and basic. So we use the footer tag, and then with some paragraphs to connect with me, and also some like the social media item icons. I decided to list them as an ordered list, which is the list number one, list two, and the third one. Okay, let's take a look at the styling of it. So in the styling, we're going to have the footer, some paragraphs, some mostly margin, button, and font weight, and then the UL tag. So yeah, and as well as the images, because each icon here is represented as an image. So I'm basically adding some maximum width to it. So let's save the file and take a look at the output result or the results. Hello, yes, everything looks pretty good. Let's take care about maybe some like responsiveness. So at the max width of 100 or 1500, we are going to maybe have a wider containers. And then when it comes to mobile phone, let's have all the text to be centered, as well as the container also to be a bit wider with less padding. And yeah, so if we take a look at now the results, looks much better. This is full screen, and let's maybe take it a bit narrower and see the results. And yeah, and that's how it would look like in the mobile phone. All right, so that's basically about it here. So there are a lot of things that you could improve in this code base, like for example, organizing those styles to be more organized. I would say these like utility classes, just have them separated, maybe group them together so it's easier to maintain and so on. But for such a basic portfolio or such a basic web page, I think that's it's good enough here so far. But again, I will be uploading, or I will be linking the description or the link to this code base, so you can basically go and maybe clone and maybe customize it, add some stuff, remove some stuff, and as well as if you have any kind of if you want to collaborate and contribute to this, maybe fix stuff or suggest better approaches, please feel free to read the README of this project, and yeah, open up a request of your changes. All right, so that's it for today. Thanks for watching. Let me know in the comments below if you have any questions. See you in the next video.